Let us read this word of God, Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 4 and 5. Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 4. When the Lord your God thrust them out before you, do not say to yourself, "It is because of my righteousness that the Lord has brought me in to occupy this land." But it is rather because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord is dispossessing them before you. So this is the word of God. So it is not because of your righteousness or the uprightness of your heart that you are going in to occupy their land, but because of the wickedness of these nations, the Lord your God is dispossessing them before you in order to fulfill the promise that the Lord has made on oath to your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. So what does it mean? When Israelites were able to defeat all the enemy nations around, and they were marching forward towards the Holy Land, Promised Land, then the Israelites started to think like this. See, we are all holy people. That's why God is protecting us and destroying everyone else. And we are all good people, and that is why we have this prosperity, we have this blessing. They don't have prosperity, they have no blessing, because they are bad people. So we are better than others. This kind of attitude is not good. The Lord says, it is not because of your righteousness I am dispossessing them. My presence is not there with them. It is because of their wickedness they were defeated. It is not because you are somebody better, or it is not because you are the best one in the whole world. It's not because you are the righteous people, but their wickedness is so bad. And it is because of their wickedness, their problems, their sins, they were dispossessed by me, the Lord says. My dear brothers and sisters, many a time we feel why God is showing partiality and God is supporting Israelites and destroying other countries or other nations or other religions. That is not the case. The Lord says, when the Lord your God thrust them out before you, do not say to yourself, it is because of my righteousness that the Lord has brought me in to occupy this land. It is rather because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord is dispossessing them. If there is something wrong with them, if there is something tragedy happened to them, it is between them and God, nothing to do with you. If you do something wrong, you will be defeated. If you do something good, you will be protected. Don't compare yourself with others. Sometimes it happens, something wrong happens to your enemies, and then suddenly you tend to think like this, oh, they did these things to me and now God is punishing them. No, God doesn't do like this. God doesn't want to be involved in the politics of the human being. God will never interfere in the politics of human being, and God never react like this based on our feelings. If something goes wrong with them, it is between them and their God. If something is happening between them and God, we are no one to intervene there in that relationship. We just make sure that we are in holiness, we are in connected to God. If something good happens, well and good. If something goes wrong, just examine our conscience and see if there is anything goes wrong in our life, anything to be rectified, and rectify it and go on. We should never compare ourselves with others and say, oh, they are the worst creatures, and therefore they did these things to us, and therefore God is punishing them, and they are not we are better than them, therefore God is doing this. No, we should never think like this. So let us read this word of God like this. It is not because of your righteousness or the uprightness of your heart that you are going in to occupy their land, but because of the wickedness of these nations, the Lord your God is dispossessing them before you. Nothing of your merit. It is because of their lack of merit. It is not because of your merit I'm just getting rid of them, but because something was going wrong in their life, in their holiness, and they are going through the consequence of it. and that's why that what they are going through, they are going through. Praise the Lord. So let us examine our conscience and see, is there anything that we need to rectify? Let us rectify. Do not ever compare ourselves with others and say we are better than others. When you are given a special occasion, special possibility, special option, possibility in front of you, maybe a better position, better place, better job, don't ever think that I'm better than all the others and that is why I'm chosen. No, not necessarily. Maybe, as we have already discussed, maybe because someone else prayer in our family, somebody in our family tree was connected to God. As a result, we are blessed. Therefore, we have nothing to compare with others. If something is gone wrong between them and God, we should not compare ourselves with others. Let's thank the Lord for every blessing God has given us and tell the Lord, Lord, help me to be faithful to you always, never to stumble and fall down in our relationship with you, Lord. Let's pray to the Lord for this intention.